we want to solve the given rational inequality and express the solution using interval notation. Step one, we write the inequality as a single quotient on the left and zero on the right. This indicates for the first step, we subtract 16 19ths on both sides of the inequality, which gives us the quantity 3x minus 1 divided by the quantity 4x plus 1 minus 16 19ths greater than or equal to 0. Now that we have 0 on the right, we still have to have a single quotient on the left, which means now we subtract. To do this, we must obtain the least common denominator, which is going to be the product of the two denominators. This indicates you multiply this first fraction by 19 divided by 19. We multiply the second fraction by the quantity 4x plus 1 divided by the quantity 4x plus 1. Notice now we do have a common denominator of 19 times the quantity 4x plus 1. We can now write the given inequality as the quantity 3x minus 1 times 19, or 19 times the quantity 3x minus 1 minus 16 times the quantity 4x plus 1, all divided by the common denominator of 19 times the quantity 4x plus 1 greater than or equal to 0. And now we need to simplify the numerator. Let's do this on the side. We have 19 times the quantity 3x minus 1 minus 16 times the quantity 4x plus 1. Clearing the parentheses, 19 times 3x is 57x, minus 19 times 1, or minus 19, minus 64x, minus 16. And combining like terms, 57x minus 64x is negative 7x, and negative 19 minus 16 gives us minus 35. We can now write the inequality in the form of negative 7x minus 35 divided by the product of 19 and the quantity 4x plus 1, greater than or equal to 0. Step 2, we now determine the zeros of the numerator and denominator. The zero of the numerator is when negative 7x minus 35 is equal to 0. Solving for x, we add 35 to both sides, divide by negative 7, and we have x equals negative 5. To find the zero of the denominator, we can ignore the 19. The denominator is 0 when 4x plus 1 equals 0. Solving for x, we subtract 1 on both sides, divide by 4. We have x equals negative 1/4. Let's record this below. The zero of the numerator is x equals negative 5. The zero of the denominator is x equals negative 1/4. Step 3, we now plot these values on the number line. The zeros of the numerator can be either open or closed points. It's always based upon the inequality. In our case, because the inequality is greater than or equal to, because of the equal part, the zero of the numerator is going to be a closed point. If it was just greater than, it would be an open point. And the zeros of the denominator, which is where we have division by zero is always undefined. The zeros of the denominator are always open points. So let's plot negative 5 as a closed point. Again, this is closed because at negative 5, the fraction is equal to 0 and the inequality is satisfied. This indicates negative 5 is part of the solution. X equals negative 1/4, let's say, is here. This is where we have division by 0, which is always undefined. We have an open point. And finally, for the last step, we need to test each of the subintervals to see which satisfy the inequality. To do this, we select test values and then sub them into either the original inequality or this equivalent inequality here. And it's always easier to compare to 0, and therefore we'll use this inequality here. Let's go ahead and select our test values. To the left of negative 5, we'll use x equals negative 6. For a value between negative 1/4 and negative 5, let's use, let's say, negative 1. And let's use 0 to the right of negative 1/4. We don't care about the exact values. We simply care about the signs of the numerator and denominator, because we can then use those signs to compare to 0. So let's first test x equals negative 6. When x is negative 6, the numerator is negative 7 times negative 6, which is 42, minus 35, which is positive. the denominator is going to be 19 times, looks like 6 times negative 4 plus 1, 19 times negative 23, which is negative. A positive divided by a negative is always negative. A negative number is never going to be greater than or equal to 0. The interval on the left is false. And now we'll test x equals negative 1. When x is negative 1, the numerator is going to be 7 minus 35, or negative. The denominator is going to be 19 times negative 3, which is negative. A negative divided by a negative is positive. A positive value will always be greater than or equal to 0. The interval in the middle is true. And now we test x equals 0. When x is 0, notice the numerator is going to be negative. The denominator is going to be positive. A negative divided by a positive is negative. A negative will never be greater than or equal to 0, and therefore the interval on the right is false. The graph of the solution is the interval marked true, which is the interval here in the middle. And now we need to give the interval using interval notation. We have the interval from negative 5 to negative 1/4. The interval is closed on negative 5 or includes negative 5, which indicates we use a square bracket to the left. The interval does not include negative 1/4. We use a parenthesis to the right. This is the solution expressed using interval notation. I hope you found this helpful.